Hey guys, I'm Shreya Tyagi. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'll be reviewing the ASUS VivoBook S14 i7 laptop. So this laptop was launched in the mid-Feb this year, and I have been using this laptop for around 3 weeks. So first of all, I'll give you a closer look to the laptop's build. Then I'll tell you all the specs and features. Then I'll show you the processor performance, the gaming performance. Then I'll list out the pros and cons. And at the end, I'll also show you the unboxing video that I shot earlier. The MRP mentioned on the box is 83k, but the online MRP is 77k, and you can easily get it for around 70-73k. I got it for 68k. This laptop is available only in this metal grey color, which by the way looks very cool and modern. The one thing that you'll appreciate immediately is that this ultrabook is damn compact and slim. My previous laptop weighed 2.8 kgs and this one weighs exactly half, 1.4 kgs. It has a 14-inch screen and hence the name S14. The charger is very compact and the adapter is just a bit bigger than a conventional phone charger. For reference, I've compared it with a Rs. 10 coin here. The adapter is detachable like all other laptop chargers and you get the Indian power cord with it. The back of the screen is full metal and is pretty solid build quality. The keyboard does not flex at all and all the keys have comfortable spaces between them making it easier to type fast. It's backlit and the brightness is adjustable. The touchpad, which is again solid build, almost blends with the rest of the body. The touch sensor here is at the top right, which I will demonstrate in a while. The bottom is plastic but has a metallic finish. The speakers which are here at the bottom are although clear and crisp with a moderate amount of bass too, are again not loud enough, making it an issue if you want to listen to something on this laptop in a noisy environment. It has one USB Type-C 3.1, one USB 3.0, two USB 2.0 ports, one HDMI, a headphone jack, and it also has a dedicated memory card reader. It obviously does not have any RJ45 disk drives or VGA port. I have not tested the Type-C USB 3.1 port yet, but the USB 3.0 port is very fast. While I was transferring some files from my external hard disk to this laptop, the transfer rates max out at around 150 megabytes per second. The HDMI port works well, but the headphone jack is just not loud enough to drive bigger headphones. It has 8GB of RAM and is powered by the i7 8th Gen U processor. But what makes it so special is that along with the 1TB hard disk, it also has an SSD, and that too 256GB. Now for those of you who don't know what's an SSD and how does it matter, an SSD is a much faster and costlier storage device than HDD. It reduces the loading time of all the applications a lot and everything runs more smoothly. Let's check out how much time does it take to boot. Here's the stopwatch and I press the power button. And done. In less than 9.5 seconds, the laptop has booted. The fingerprint sensor takes less than a second to log you in. The display is 1920 by 1080 and is one of the best displays I've seen on a laptop. The colors and details are super accurate and even the black levels and contrast is impressive. Here is an untouched 59 second Blu-ray video sample on the screen. Just notice the superb amount of detail. Now to check the processor, I'll crop and convert this video to a high quality format using command line FFmpeg video converter. While doing this conversion, it is utilizing the processor to a full 100% and the clock speed is fluctuating between 2.5 to 3 GHz. The max clock speed is 4 GHz which it hits occasionally like now. The conversion took 20 seconds only, which is much faster than the i5 and i5 HQ processor which I tested a few weeks ago. Now because of the SSD, every app loads in a blink. One of the heaviest softwares, Adobe Premiere Pro, also loads quickly. The benchmark results are impressive and you can download the full report from the link in the description. Now coming to gaming. This laptop does not have a dedicated graphics card, which means the gaming performance for heavy games is below average. Let me show you GTA 5's gameplay at 1080p resolution and normal settings. You can see the frame rate here at the top left. The frame rate is fluctuating between 12Hz to 15Hz, and for a laptop which does not have a graphic card at all, it's pretty good, but from a gamer's point of view, it sucks. Let me turn down the resolution from 1080p to 720p. It makes the game more playable. As you can see now, the frame rates are pretty fine.
Something don't feel too good.
When you drop out of a vehicle, the frame rate suddenly increases to 30Hz, but still there are occasional frame drops. So in short, if you want to buy a laptop to play a lot of games, don't buy this one. Now the pros and cons. First, let's check out the cons. Con 1. No caps lock indicator light. Con 2. No graphics card. Con 3. Pathetic webcam, it's 480p VGA. Con 4. Volume level issues with both the headphone as well as the speakers. Pro 1. very clear audio recording through the microphone. Pro 2, very good display. Pro 3, super fast processor speeds. Pro 4, fast charging and a very long battery life. Pro 5, compact, lightweight and portable. So make your decisions according to your need, and as I said, the unboxing video is at the end.